Hey folks, and welcome back to Tight Lines Outdoors. Today we're going to look back at our summer walleye season and discuss the two methods we had the most success with. That is bottom bouncing worm harnesses and lead core trolling. So stay tuned for some tight lines. Fishing for walleye in upstate New York, especially in the Adirondack region, comes with a number of challenges. First, viable bodies of water that hold quality populations are far and few between. Second, understanding their behavior during different times of the year requires becoming familiar with the structures and locations the walleye could be holding on in the lakes you are fishing. Weed beds, flats, humps, and drop-offs are all potential areas to find walleye. And lastly, there are a variety of techniques, baits, and lures that can be used to catch walleye, but their success depends upon the time of day and the time of year. Walleye are generally found towards the bottom of most lakes and rivers, so we have focused our techniques to target these groups of fish. Bottom bouncing and lead core trolling provides us with an opportunity to get our baits in the strike zone and allow us to cover a lot of area in the process. Bottom bouncing is one of the techniques we use to catch walleye. We use a worm harness and typically a 1 ounce bottom bouncer. And the one thing that we have to do here in the lakes that we fish is weed through a lot of the other species, in particular the panfish, the sunnies, pumpkin seeds, bluegills and such. Obviously they love the worms and you're gonna catch your fair share of them. One of the interesting things that we have figured out is if you catch enough of these panfish in the walleye, they have a different bite, so to speak. The panfish are going to have this rapid fire, almost machine gun type tapping on your worm and the harness, and your rod tip is going to move very, very quickly, whereas the walleye is going to load your rod a little bit. It's going to sit in heavy on the worm and allow you to set the hook that way. So when you do catch enough of them, you kind of realize what you're up against. Let me show you the setup that we're using today. So here's our 1 ounce bottom bouncer. And it's attached to approximately a 3 foot leader with a worm harness on, okay? So you can see the blade and the beads and then obviously the live night crawler that goes along with it. And the idea behind the bottom bouncing is just to have this ticking the bottom. So the worm harness is sitting approximately a foot or two off the bottom at most. And the idea is to get it to drag right across those walleyes that are just belly to the bottom, almost enticing them to eat it as it goes by their face. So that's what we're using today. All right, looks like I'm on right now. Hopefully it is an eye. Yep, it is. It's a nice looking eye right here. Okay, we're in the boat. Here it is. Very nice. About an 18 incher. So you can see that this technique is really effective in catching walleye. Really happy with this one. This one's gonna go in the box. We're gonna have this one for dinner. When you're bottom bouncing walleyes, you're gonna have to weed through a lot of the panfish. And you can see, I mean, some of these panfish are absolutely beautiful. They're huge. This is a big bluegill. But you're gonna catch probably 10, 15, even 20 of these for every walleye that you hook up into. But they're a lot of fun to catch nonetheless. This is a big one. We're gonna put her back. Fishing with two lines in the water and I end up getting a double. These panfish are absolutely gorgeous. So this is a pumpkin seed and this is a bluegill. You're going to catch tons of them while you're trying to weed out and find those walleye. But you know, they're still a blast to catch and they're really good eating, but that's not what we're out here for today. So these guys are going to go back in the water. I'm currently fishing a weed line in about 15 to 16 feet of water while I like to take cover in the weeds, and they'll come out and grab whatever prey swims by, and hopefully they'll grab my worm harness. But usually we're looking for some sort of structure that they can hide in, and I'm getting a bite right here, loading up. Got him. Feels like a good one. Oh, that's a nice walleye. Here we go. Decent walleye. Definitely a keeper. One of the things that I mentioned earlier is that you could actually feel them loading up on your bait as opposed to the panfish that are going to tap, tap, tap. These guys load up and you can really tell the difference between the two species when you're fishing with a crawler harness. So we'll put this guy in the box. Nice walleye, another nice one. Again, it's once you've caught a few of these, you can actually feel the difference in how they load the rod versus the tapping motion of the bite you get with panfish. So it's another nice walleye. Thank you.
on another one here. Definitely fighting like a walleye. This one's down. Good walleye. About a 15 and a half, 16 inch walleye. Took the black and gold F13 Rapala. So that's a keeper fish here. They've got to be 15 inches. We're releasing everything tonight. But that could be a keeper if you wanted to take some home. And that's not a bad fish for this body of water that we're fishing.
Wanted to show you guys some of the many different types of baits that we use when we're fishing for walleye with lead core. This is my perch box. It's actually a lure lock box. Got them this year. I absolutely love them. Keeps the baits in place without getting the hooks tangled and whatnot. But at any rate, you can see that we have a variety of different baits and we've tried all of these. What we found is the stick baits work the best for us, at least in the body of waters that we fish. In particular, the Rapala baits, the F11s, F13s, seem to work really well. Certainly the shad wraps have produced their share of fish too. We have some live target baits in here, and we have some Berkeley pit bulls here as well. So all of these have produced fish, and depending upon, like I said, the conditions and how the bite is going, you're gonna have to play with the different types of lures. And that's the beauty of lead core, is you can mix and match and kind of figure it out. I'll put up on the screen a number of different photos that we took. We try to match the hatch all summer long, including using baits that look like baby bluegill, bass, and even a log perch, which we thought was really cool. Those were all baits that the walleye had thrown up, or when we were filleting them, we found them in their bellies. So these are just a few of the many different baits that we use, and you'll see throughout the video that we're using a ton of different other baits as well. So be creative, figure out what you think works best for the body of water that you're fishing in.
Mick is hooked up again. Using lead core line is a great technique for us because we're targeting the walleye that sit on the bottom of the lake. And this line allows us to dial in our lures at different depths, notably towards the bottom. Got to use a little math, a couple variables associated with it as far as speed and the weight of your lead core line. But overall, you could really zone in on where the fish are, and that's a really nice walleye that Mick just picked up.
A little bit bigger fish.
Yep, real nice. Good stuff.
We'll take them.
Back in the drink.
All right, another one in the boat. Might be a little short, close to 15 maybe. What's really satisfying is you can see the fish on the graph, and then within a couple minutes you know your lure, if you're dialed in with it with the lead core, is going to pull right in front of these guys. And that's the end result right there. So, nice little fish, going back in the water tonight.
Yeah, nice one.
So we doubled up. The bite's really starting to pick up. We're kind of in the golden hour right now. So again, the lead core is really producing on days like this where there's overcast and you can just draw that bait right across their noses when they're belly to the bottom. So it's starting to really pay off for us right now. Thank you.
have to have a chance to see him. Every night I have a stranger's dream. Impressed by the way I could have been. Left you on my own, all so at sea.
Walleye are an extremely sought-after game fish, but they're not always easy to catch. We hope that the techniques we discussed in our video will help you boat a few of these toothy bottom dwellers. Thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed our video, hit the like button and please subscribe to our channel. We hope to have more content for you soon, so until then, tight lines, everyone.